Hello learners, in today's class we'll discuss the two hinged arches we have discussed in the last class, that is the parabolic arch. And today we'll develop some formulations for horizontal thrust in case of a circular arch. So let us draw a circular arch. Now the circular arch two hinged arch, and let the reaction start A and B. So this is A, this is B, and the reactions here is H, and as you know, H will remain same on both sides because sigma H zero horizontal thrust. So let there be concentrated loads W on both sides of the arch, resistance A from these supports, as we have seen in the last problem also. So this is A, this is also A. And the let be the circular arc. So radius of the arc is equal to R. Now take this is as your line joining here, and looking at this point. So this point is O. This is joining with the crown. So the two angles, let this angle is equal to theta, and this angle is equal to phi. Let us take some section at here at a distance, and if we join with this point, let this be at an angle beta here, beta. So now this is equal to D. This is equal to C, and this load is at a distance x from the crown. And again, we are doing this section. Now let this distance is equal to y. We load at distance y from this line connecting the spring, and this distance is your rise. Rise is nothing, is your y c. All are the nomenclatures for these two hinged arcs. Now we'll take sections like previous case. X is equal to 0 and x is equal to at A. So you can find your reactions will be again W into W. Okay. Now we'll take distance x from C. Bending moment at x is equal to 0 and x is equal to at A. So now you take sections. So what will the reactions you can find out now from between C and W? There is just mean 0 to this 0 to L by 2 like this value, and there is no load. So you can find out these values now. If we'll take x from this side, okay, at any section x, you can find this reaction will be W into x is the bending moment. So don't take this as the x value. Let okay. So this is your W value. Now if we'll take x value here, W into x is the bending moment, okay, and your m dash between x less than x less than a, okay. Now between again a to l by 2, a to l by 2 will find the same thing as you have found. If we'll take this value, you can find that will come m is equal to W into a W into a minus W into x minus a. So W into x minus W into x minus a, which will come is equal to W into a. So these are the values you'll get for this bending moment. Now what the value of x? Let us see the value of x. R sine alpha. So it will take minus sine theta. So the total value, one will come alpha and beta. Okay. Both angles same. So this distance will be R sine alpha, and this distance will be R sine beta. So now what is the value of x? And you can take any angle alpha you can take. So this is equal to R, right? So what is this distance? This is R sine beta. And if any intersection here, and if this angle is alpha, so what is this distance? R sine alpha. So you can find out the difference these two things, that x is equal to R sine alpha minus R sine beta. So total value you can find out. So now go up. What is x? X is equal to R sine alpha minus sine theta. So this angle is theta, so the total will be R sine theta, right? The total value will be R sine theta. Now if we take any value alpha here, any section at x, this angle is alpha, so you can find out. Suppose you will take this is alpha, okay, you find this value, so this will be R sine alpha. So total distance R sine theta minus R sine alpha is equal to x. So what is a value? A means this distance a. So total distance again R sine alpha minus sine beta you can find out. So R sine alpha minus sine beta. Okay. Now you can find out value of y. What is y? This distance y. So the total will be R cos theta and R cos alpha. So you can find any section x, so that will be R cos alpha minus R cos theta. So this is theta, so this is R. You can find R cos theta is coming, this value is R cos theta. And this value will come, take any section R sine alpha, so we can find out R into cos theta minus cos alpha. So now what is ds? If we take some length ds, that will be R into d theta. Any length you will find out along the chord, so ds will be equal to R d theta. I will come to this problem again. Now one we have find out w is equal to what is w into x and w into a. The two things we have found out from this relationship, bending moment. One was one bending moment was w into x, right? And other bending moment was, in the second case we have found w into a. So now these two values will be substituted here. So we'll find out w into r sine alpha minus sine theta. R sine alpha minus sine theta. So r will come outside. Similarly, w into a will come, w into r sine alpha minus sine beta. Sine alpha minus sine beta. Now you have to integrate these values, and both sides are same, so it will be multiplied 2 times 0 to a, and then you can find out from 0 to a, and then L to a or a to beta. If you take any section at distance beta, you can find the value between a to beta to a. So take two values and we'll find out the total energy, that is your m into y into ds. Ds is equal to r d theta, right? Y is equal to r into cos theta minus cos alpha, and we have the value of bending moment we have found for two different sections. Now put all these in the equation format. So you have to integrate all the things two times because we are taking half of this circular arcs. So other side from circular arcs, you will find the other side. We can find this value. So we can put these things in format. So two times. You can find 0 to beta. So that is come your w into r. So w into r into sine alpha minus sine beta, that is w into x, sine alpha minus sine beta. Okay. Then your value will come y. Y we have seen r into cos theta minus cos alpha, r into cos theta minus cos alpha. Okay. Then ds, ds into r d. Now here the only variable is your theta, other things remaining constant. So you have to integrate this plus. Then again w into r, w into a. So then you have to integrate from values from 0 to a. Okay. Then put these values, what the value coming? R d theta, here r, that will be r q. That will be RQ. So put these values on both sides. One is from 0 to beta and then beta to A. Beta to A. So beta to A, again you can find out this value W into A. So put that value W into R sine alpha minus sine beta. Okay. Sin alpha minus sin beta multiply with then your a. Okay, a we have already found out, r into cos theta minus cos alpha, cos theta minus cos alpha. Okay. Then multiply by ds, that is r d theta. Now you have to integrate the entire things and then find out the final result. So I am not going in details on this integration parts. So you can integrate yourself and find the final result. And if you go on doing this, you will find out finally the value will come as value will come as your 2w. We'll go step by step and do all these integrations. 2 into w into rq, okay, multiplied by sine square alpha minus sine square beta. Sin square alpha minus sin square beta. Okay. Then it will come minus 2 cos alpha minus 2 cos alpha into cos alpha minus cos beta, cos alpha minus cos beta. Then plus alpha sine alpha minus beta sine beta. Alpha sine alpha minus beta And similarly, you can also find out this derivation for y square ds. Okay, you can find the derivation for y square ds integration from then do from 0 to L integration. You can find the y square ds, and here it will come from minus a to plus a, or you can take 2 times 0 to 0 to a. And you can put y square is equal to r square. Again, you know the values, that is cos theta minus cos alpha. What is r value? y value we have found out r cos theta minus cos alpha whole square. So cos theta minus cos alpha into ds. Again, ds means r d theta. Okay. So this thing can be integrated to find out the value. So this will come as, if you do the integrations, that will come in the range r q into 4 alpha cos square alpha, 4 alpha cos square alpha plus 2 alpha minus 3 sin 2 alpha. Okay. 3 sin 2 alpha. Now, because there is a symmetrical both sides, there is horizontal values. You can take 2x is equal to this 0 to L m dash y ds by 0 to L y square. I will divide both the things and simplify, we'll find some values. Okay. So this is for general circular arc. If it is a semicircular arc, alpha value is pi by 2, then things will be easier. So we'll find this dividing both the things, you will find h will come as, a very long formula will come, w into that value we have find here, this y square ds, and then you have find out also the h value, 2 w r q sin square alpha minus all these divided by this. Now if we put the specific case for semicircular arcs, alpha is equal to pi by 2. Alpha is equal to pi by 2, will find out the h value will come. Alpha is equal to pi by 2, the special case for the semicircular arcs, the value of h will come as w cos square beta by pi. W cos square beta by pi. This is the value will come as h. And if the load acting at the crown, the load acting on the crown, that means beta is equal to 0 degree. So if beta is 0 degree, then h will be equal to w by pi. So this is a very specific case. If it is a semicircular arc and load is acting at the crown of this semicircular arc, then the horizontal thrust is equal to w by pi. So this is a very specific case for the semicircular arc. So if you have to derive the formula directly for semicircular arcs, it things will be very easy. Okay, because it will be from only 0 to pi by 2, you can do the integrations. So integration become easier. So this formulation is for a generalized circular arcs, but for a specific semicircular arcs, and that too the load is acting at the center, at the crown, then the horizontal thrust is equal to w by pi. You can remember this formula, and h is equal to w by pi for a concentrated load acting at the crown. And let us see a problem on this. You take a semicircular arc. Okay, you will take Now, one of these problems, we can say, you take a example. This example, let us take a semicircular arch like this, okay? Now, this will be your H, and this will be your V, okay? VA, and this will be here H, and this will be your VB. Now, if you put the loads, the loads are acting at these different points. Suppose it is acting at crown, load acting at crown, nothing 100 kilonewton. This load is 100 kilonewton, okay. And there is 60 kilonewton at different angles. Suppose you will put this formula, there is loads acting at different angles. At 60, this is angle 60 degree, okay. At 60 degree, there is a load acting which is equal to 80 kilonewton. Okay. Then there is a load acting at 45 degree on 30 degree, and this load is this is a suppose 30 degree, and the load is acting here is 120 kilonewton. Okay, and there is another load acting here at 45 degree. At 45 degree, there is a load acting, and which is equal to 60 kilonewton. Okay, and this is suppose 20 meter length from the support to support, and this radius or the rise is YC is equal to 10 meter given in the question. Okay, so you have to find out this horizontal thrust for the member. Okay. Now, what you can do, the horizontal thrust for a semicircular arch, and the solution that we have known that H is equal to, for a concentrated load, H is equal to W cos square beta by pi. So, this is the formula for finding the horizontal thrust for a semicircular arch, that in that case your alpha is pi by 2. Now we are considering semicircular arch. Now what we can do now, this H you can find out for different angles, for angle 30 degree, for angle 60 degree, for angle 90 degree, for angle 45 degree, and all the horizontal thrust found for different case can be added to find the final H value. Are you getting my point? At you can find this for 30 degree, what the value W is equal to 120 kilonewton into cos square 30 by pi. For 60 degree, it is 80 into cos square 60 by pi. For 100 kilonewton, 100 cos square 90 by pi. And for 60 kilonewton, you can find 60 cos square 45 degree by pi. And all these can be added, and we can find out the final value. So find out all these values. Suppose you firstly find for 45 degree. What is H1? H1 for 45 degree will be 60 into cos square 45 degree, right? Divided by pi. Then you can, this value is called coming 30 by pi. Similarly, we can find H2 for the value of theta is equal to when vertical. That means angle is measured from the vertical, so angle is 0 degree. So the load is given 100. So 100 cos square 0 by pi. Okay. We can find out this value. This comes out to be 100 by pi. Similarly, you can find out H3. That is for the 60 degree angle, so it will be 80 cos square, but the beta value, beta is measured from the here, okay, so this angle will be 30 degree, so cos square 30 divided by pi, so this comes 60 by pi. Then you can find out at the value of for H4 at the angle for this angle 30 degree, but beta is measured from the crown, so that angle will be 60 degree. So H4 for the value of 120 kilonewton will be 120 into cos square 60, because the beta value is measured from the crown. So it is 30, means this will be 60 divided by 5. Okay, this will come 30 by 5. Now you add all the four values. So what is the value of h? Now h will be equal to h1 plus h2 plus h3 plus h4. So add all these values, h2 plus h3 plus h4, right? And this total will give you the value of 220 by pi. 120, sorry, 30, 60, 100, 30. So 30, 30, 60, 60, 100, 20, 220 by pi. So this much of kilonewton will come, that will come only 70.03 kilonewton. Okay. So it is very easy for a semicircular arch. If you are going for a semicircular arch and you will find out this horizontal thrust, put the formula directly. But for circular arch, there is a very long formula which is not easy to remember. So you can also derive separately. You can take as a home task to find out for a semicircular arch how to find the h by integrating this energy, and you'll find it will come as w cos square beta by pi. So that will give the value. I think you understood directly. For semicircular arch, it is very semicircular arch with concentrated loads. Put the formula directly that h for a particular load is equal to w cos square beta by pi, where beta is measured from the crown. Now let us see the derivation. If there is a two-hinged parabolic arch, okay, now let us take a two-hinged parabolic arch, and this parabolic arch subjected to UDL. We have seen in the last class, we have discussed that parabolic arch with this point loads. Okay, we have got a formula and we can found that. Now here is this a parabolic arch, two-hinged parabolic arch, right? Parabolic arch with UDL throughout. So now you have a UDL that uniformly distributed load throughout this. What is the value of horizontal thrust? You have to find out. Now again, here this length is equal to L, and this value is your YC, right? YC is your crown. And if you remember well, we have already found out that this value of 8 by 15 YC square, L is your value of Y square DX. That was already you can again derive these values. We have seen in also last class the y square ds integration from 0 to L for these parabolic arcs, that is your the required one bit term for calculation. We have found it has come out 8 y c square L by 15. This we have already derived, so we don't go to again to find here. And again, in case of the parabolic arch, this y is nothing, your 4h by L square into x into L minus x, right? Now, when it is provided UDL, uniform distributed load, what is the value you have to find out? The bending moment. So, what is the bending moment at any section? You can find out bending moment at any section is equal to w into x. Into this value will be w into x into x by L into L minus x. So it will take at any distance x from here. Okay. So what is the value of your bending moment? This reaction will be w L by 2, right? And what is the bending moment? Bending moment at any section x will be m is equal to w L by 2 into x minus w x square by 2, right? Now if you'll integrate this from 0 to L, rather than going to 0 to L, we have to find 0 to L by 2, and then we can calculate this value of bending moment. Okay. Now this UDL is continuous throughout this span 0 to L, so you can integrate this value from 0 to L, let us do this problem. Now, what is the integration of 0 to L m y dx? So this is our requirement. Now, what is m? M is equal to this, that is your w L by 2 into x into w x square by 2. Okay. So w L by 2 into then take the common value x minus w x square by 2. If we take x outside, it will be l by 2 minus x by 2, or it will be l minus x. So whatever may be, this is the value. This multiply by y. What is y? Y is equal to 4 h by l square into x into l minus x and dx. So you have to integrate this from 0 to l. Then now if we take the outside the values, that 4 h by l square will come outside, then here 2 w l by 2 in w by 2 into w by 2 can come outside, and it will cancel out, it will be 2 w y c divided by l square into 0 to l, okay, x square into l minus x whole square to dx. How to integrate this? So I'm not going into it, because you will take your common x outside, it will be l minus x, l minus into l minus x whole square, x into x, x square. If you integrate these and put the values, this value will come as w y c l square, w y c l cube by 15. So do the integrations, put the values of this boundary 0 to L on the integration parts, and then you can find the final integrated value is W by C by D. So this is the numerator and denominator. We have found Y is equal to 8 by 5 by 8, that value we have found out, Y square DS. Okay. What was the Y square DS value? 8 by 15 y three square l. Now you divide both the things, so then you can find out the value of what is the value of this h? H will be divided by this and this top and bottom. Top was w y c l cube by 15 divided by. The bottom value was 8 y c square l square divide, sorry, l y c square into l divided by 8 y c square l by 15, 8 by 15 y c square l. Now if we will cancel each other and simplify, it will come w l square by 8 y c. This is your h value for parabolic arcs with UDL. Parabolic arcs with UDL, you can find out this value as w l square by 8 y c is the integrated value. So for anything you can find out these values of this semicircular arcs and parabolic arcs. Now what you can do, let us do a problem. Let's do another problem here. Let us take two inch parabolic arcs. Another example, Puinist parabolic arch is given, where this rise is 4 meter and span is 20 meter. Okay, like this, span is 20 meter, and the rise is given 4 meter. Okay, parabolic arch, and it is loaded with a load like a triangular load, like this. This is now loaded like this. A triangular load varies from 0 at one end and 15 other one. 0 at here and 50 kilonewton per meter at this point. What the value of H? Now think about this problem. How we can find out by the available formulas already we have with this. We have already derived that WL square by 8YC is for this value of H for a UDL throughout this parabolic arch. Now, what we can do, we can divide into like this. Now, if you complete a triangle into a rectangle, now it is equal to 50 kilonewton throughout. And this load is half of that. So what we can see, you take a full UDL 50 kilonewton per meter, whatever value of H will find here, half of that will for the 0 to 50 triangular variation. So that becomes easy for to calculate. So what we can do is the solution that 2H is equal to WL square by 8YC. This is not H. We have found H for earlier case. Now you are dividing the load in two parts. One is acting from here to here, okay, 50 to 0, another 0 to 50. We combine, it is H for this 0 to 50, and then another H will also for 50 to 0. Okay.
Okay.
So we can take 2H is equal to this. So put the values. So now 50 into L square is 20 square. Divided by 8 into 4, which comes out to be 625 kilonewton. What the value of H? Now the value of H will be equal to half of this, 625 by 2. It will take 625 by 2 equal to 312.5 kilonewton, the load coming for this. Similarly, you can find out these values for a full UDL or half UDL. Now, let us do a problem, another problem for half UDL. Okay, this was a triangular load. Now, let us take a parabolic arch. Now, this parabolic arch is another example. In this parabolic arch, it is subjected to a load of 40 kilonewton meter, the half of the span. The half of the span, you have 40 kilonewton per meter. Okay. This is 8 meter, and total is 36 meter. So half of this is equal to 18 meter. From here to here it is 18 meter. Now calculate the horizontal thrust for this problem. So we can directly find out these values by the any method. Or you can put this from the basic equations and try to solve it. Now, what is the total load here? 40 into 18, 720 kilonewton. Okay. Now, so you have to first find out the reactions. You can find the reactions directly, or you can find the other method. What you can do directly, total load is suppose throughout the span. So you can find out the H by the formula WL square by 8YC, and half of that can be taken as for this reaction. Okay, this is straightforward. You can find out the solution. So one can going the detail calculations. What you can say? Okay, now this is your reactions on both sides. Okay, so this is H. This is H. So like the previous problem, what you can say? We can say that the load is totally UDL throughout the span and half up like this. So if the total load is equal to H, then you can take half of that will be for this UDL. Okay. Now providing throughout the span, what will formula? 2H is equal to WL square by 8YC. What does that mean? That means I give this and also I give another load like this. Okay. So for this load, there is a development of horizontal thrust both side H and H, and for this also there is a development H and H, which means. So we can take the value 2H like this, or we can find out H for the full load and divide by the H to half of this value. That will give the value of this horizontal thrust. So put the value. So W is 40 into 36 square divided by 8 into rise is equals also 8. So it comes out to be 810 kilonewton. Okay. So horizontal thrust can be calculated over the entire span like this. So you can find value of H will be half of this value. So this is one method. In the other method, you can go for integrating the things from the basics. So I will start with the basics. That means you take this, find the reactions first. Do the reaction here. This is the alternate method. The alternate method is you can directly put the values and get this solution for that. Let us find out the reaction first. Now the total load is 40 into 18. So this value comes out to be 720 kilonewton. Now if you find the reaction, out of this 1/4 will go to this side and 3/4 will go to that side. So or you can what you can do, you find the basic equations. At your VA plus VB is equal to total load is 40 into 18, that is equal to 720 kilonewton. And take moment about this point A, you can find out VB into 36. That is equal to already 720 the load multiply by CG. CG half will be 18 by 2. So you can find the value of VB. VB comes out to be 224180 kilonewton. So VB will be 184 kilonewton, and automatically VA will be equal to 540 kilonewton. Now what is the value of YC? You can find YC. YC is equal to 4H by L square into X into L minus X. Okay. So that the value X into L minus X. If we try to solve it, then L is equal to 36. So 4 into 36 into 36. Multiply by X into L minus X. So you can get this value comes out to be 1 by 9 36. x l is equal to again 36. So you can solve this problem. That means it will come. It will take 4 means 36 cancel. Then 4 by 6 that will be x by 9. Okay. So let us do this. So 4 into h. So h value we have not added here. 4 into h is equal to 8. So now 32 into 36 is 36. If you expand this, l is equal to again 36. So 36 will cancel. And 4 by 9, so it will be 8 by 9. 8 by 9 into x minus. Then here will come 4 by 9. Then 8 means 2 by 18. Okay. So in front it will come 2 by 81. 2 by 81 x square. So 4 is 9. So 4 means 2, 4 means 9. 9, 9, 81. So 2 by 81 will come the solution. Now this is the value of YC. Now you find the bending moment between x from, you take a distance from A, and what is the bending moment? You put the value because you don't know where the bending moment will be zero. Put the value of bending moment at distance x, which comes out to be 540x, okay, minus 20 your h into y, okay, h into y, and minus, sorry, that will be also minus 40 into x by 2, double x square by 2, then minus hy. So it will come out to be 540x minus 20x square into minus h, okay, h into y. Y already find out 8 by 9 x into, so you can write here 8 by 9 x minus 2 by 18, 81 x square. So this is for h and this is for your h into y. So we are not going for the calculation of this part because h into y will come separately. Bending moment due to only loads. So 540x minus is this. So h and y will not take here. We'll simple take 540x okay minus w x square by 2. Okay, so this will come as bending moment at distance x. If you take total bending moment and find dmx by dx0, you can find the value of x, and then you can put all these values to find the maximum bending moment that you can also do. So in that case, you find the maximum bending moment due to all these loads, then you have to put h, okay, h into y. Y is equal to 8 by 9x minus 2 by 81x. Okay. Now, where the bending moment maximum? For the bending moment to maximum, we have to and h we have already found out. H already we have found out. You can find out this value is 800. We have found 810. Okay, so you can put the value half of that. That is 405. Okay, so you can put the value 405 here. H value. And try to write the equation. Now this is the bending moment at any section. So where the maximum bending will occur? To find the maximum bending moment, we have to put dmx by dx is equal to 0. So now put the value d dmx by dx is equal to 0, dmx by dx is equal to 0. So you have to make the d by dx of all these things, and then find the solution. It will come, if you solve this mx, it comes out be 180x minus 10x square. This is equal to 0. Dmx by dx means it will be 180x means it will be 180 minus 20x is equal to 0. So x is equal to 9. At x is equal to 9, you have to find the maximum bending moment. So at x is equal to 9, what is the value of your yc? Yc will be at x is equal to 9. What is yc? 4h by l square into x into l minus x. So if you put these values, yc will come out to be 6 meter. You put that equation 4h by l square already we have derived into x into l minus x. Find yc will come 6 meter. Okay. What the maximum bending moment you will find? The maximum bending moment, m maximum, will be equal to 540 into 9 minus wx square by 2, 40 into 9 square by 2 minus h into y, h is 405 multiply by y is equal to 6. So that comes out to be 810 kilonewton meter. Okay. So in this problem, we have been asked to find out the maximum bending moment for this maximum. Also, you can also find maximum positive and maximum bending moment in the similar fashion. The maximum positive bending moment will be obtained by taking the positive moment value. But you can also find out the maximum negative bending moment, that it can come from the distance B. The positive one coming from distance A, and negative one will come from distance B. You can find that value. Now, the maximum to find out the maximum positive and maximum bending moment for this problem, you have to find out this H first. So, as I have told, because it is parabolic arch with half UDL. So you have derived a formula that parabolic arch with a full UDL throughout span, the value of this bending moment comes out to be as a standard value. That value is coming double L square by 8YC. So the H value is double L square by 8YC. What is the half UDL? So half of both sides will come. So the H value here comes. For 2H is equal to 810. So H comes out to be 405 kilonewton. Now, once you find this H value, then bending moment at any section, you have to find the maximum bending moment for this 2-inch arch. So bending moment at any section, whether it is half UDL, so from these basics, you can find there will be a positive bending moment, there will be also negative bending moment in this case. So maximum bending moment will occur under the load. So we can find, take a section at distance x from this support and find out what is the bending moment equation. So bending moment equation, as we have discussed, that at any distance x, bending moment, suppose you will take this is equal to x. So what is the bending moment? So bending moment will be equal to this vertical reaction into x minus this UDL into x by 2 minus this h into this y value. So you can find the equation for y. H value is already known. H is will be equal to half of this, that is 405 kilonewton. Okay. So if you are interested to find the maximum positive bending moment, then you have to write the equation. Now the equation will come in terms of x. So where we find the maximum bending moment? That means we have to take the derivative of the equation with respect to x is equal to 0. So by solving the equation, you can find the value of x is coming, x is equal to 9 meter. If x is coming 9 meter, then find out the value of yc at s is equal to 9, which comes out to 6 meter y value, and then put in the equation to find out the bending moment. So the maximum positive bending moment comes out to be 810 kN. Similarly, you can find the maximum negative bending moment. You can say a distance x from this end B. If you will take this, this is the end B. The maximum negative bending moment occurs a distance x from B. If you will take distance x from B, then write the equation for the bending moment again, Vb into x, and then this Vb into x minus h into y will be equal to 0, and we can find out the value of maximum negative bending moment. And again, y is equal to 4h l square into x l minus x. You can put this value. It will be very simple. So if you take maximum negative bending moment, it will be at distance x from B. So this is 180. So 180 into x minus y into h into y. Okay. So let us put that value. What you will get? Now come. What is your next task? To find out maximum negative bending moment. What is the maximum negative bending moment? Negative bending moment for this arch. For maximum negative moment, what will do? Now you will take from the distance B. Okay, this is the B value. A distance x from B, that will be maximum negative moment. So this is your Vb. Vb we have already found out 180 kN, right? And h we have already found out 405 kN. Now, what is the value of bending moment here? So bending moment is simple. The maximum bending moment will be equal to here Vb into x minus h into y. 180 into x minus h is equal to 405. Y already we have found in terms of x. We have already found out that is 8x by 9 minus 2 by 81 x square. So now this is your equation. So put the value where the maximum bending moment bm by dx is equal to 0. Again you will take if you simplify it, again comes the same value 10x square minus 180x, and again x will come is equal to 9. Okay. If you put x is equal to 9, and we'll put this value of in the equation, we'll find the maximum negative bending moment. Again will come as 810 kN/m. Similar way. So if you make here, you'll find the maximum negative bending moment. Maximum negative moment, you take dmx by dx is equal to 0. By taking dmx by dx is equal to 0, you'll find out x is equal to 0, means you'll find it 20x minus 180, x is equal to 9 meter. Again, we'll put the equation x is equal to 9. We'll find the maximum negative bending moment maximum. Again, it's coming 810 kN/m. So we discuss in this problem how to find the maximum positive and maximum negative moment. So to find the maximum positive negative moment, you must know the value of h. So first find out the horizontal thrust, then write the bending equation for any section x, and then put the dm by dx 0, and which will give the value of x. So by taking the value of x from the solution, again put the bending equation to find out the maximum positive. Similar way, you can find the maximum negative from the end B. So with this, we conclude this class. We will discuss some problems also in the next class on this two-inch diagram.